I have a lot of people to thank, you find on the first page of the research, and I begin. Science has demonstrated the last time that effects of loss of parental care and abuse on well-being of the children. For example, a little example, if genetically inclined, children will have in their lives a greater risk of panic disorder if they had the history of parental loss. So we can say that parental loss into the most authoritative scientific literature. On psychological endocrinology, three months ago, a very interesting research found a separation in childhood and adult inflammation. The English researchers have demonstrated that CRP levels, an inflammatory protein that is correlated with type 2 diabetes, coronary heart disease, depression, and a lot of disease more, are increased in children of adults coupled. That's very interesting. These are organic damage. The study points towards potential points for intervention and highlights the need to support separating families. And why we have this modification of CRP levels? By a change of disadvantage across the life course. The Journal of Psychiatric Research recently, 5 months ago, published this article, Association of Elevated Cytokines with Childhood Obesity in a Sample of Healthy Adults. And what is very important is that this alteration may precede the development of significant stress-related psychiatric disorder or disease. So it was found in healthy adults, but the cause was in the childhood. What is the first cause of parental loss in Western countries? We are not talking about Syria, about Afghanistan. We don't have war anymore. The first cause now is the divorce. And more than 10 million of European minors are children of divorced couples. Very interesting, direct action on chromosomes. This is an unbelievable outcome. Adverse childhood events are related to continued vulnerability among older adults, enhancing the impact of chronic stress factors. It means more psychiatric disorders, and only for adults, has been demonstrated to lead to an increase of metabolic disease, cancers, lung disease. So the action of the stress in the childhood make it weaker, the terminal portion of the chromosome, the telomeric portion. The chromosome will be weaker all the life long. It will be easier to develop important disease. A lot of demonstration about influence on hormonal assessment, the experience of stress in childhood negatively correlates with plasma oxytocin concentration in adult men. Oxytocin, the hormone of the falling in love. And this could explain why, for example, the children of divorced couples, I mean traumatic divorce, they have a bad relation with the other sex or with the adults, because they have an alteration of oxytocin concentration. Epigenetic regulation of glucocorticoid receptor, this is correlated with childhood abuse. Now with child abuse, probably in the future, when the research will be more advanced, we can demonstrate even the role of parental loss. The glucocorticoid are the hormones of stress, the stress hormone. Now, a simple question for the kind of public that come here. Are these ones arguments of family rights? For sure, pensions, alimonies, the houses, the properties, these are arguments of family rights, but for sure, not the behaviors to protect the children from organic and inorganic damage. Here we have a misunderstanding. So the first take-home message that I want to leave you in Strasbourg, I pray you to bring to your countries, is that now, co-parenting, it's not just a juridic, anthropological, sociological concept anymore. But mainly, in the first approach, is a scientific issue. So we can see that the competence you have heard, Honorable Angelilli, should be not only of the Justice Commission, but more probably of the Health Commission. Unfortunately, this is the answer everybody has heard from the lips of Honorable Angelilli. The definition of joint custody belongs to substantive family law. As such, it does not fall within European Union competence, but remains under the sole responsibility of the member states. This explains why there may be difference, maybe, perhaps, in the national systems as regards the definition of joint custody especially how it works in practice. I don't agree. In principle, it's a question of health, and Europe has wide competence in this area. The second take-home message: parental loss and psychological stress can cause organic damage, not only on tangible psychological pain. Parental loss can have dramatic consequences, and sheer equal counseling would be a good instrument to prevent parental loss. I point on this important research. It's a French research, but you can find on the website in double version, French version, English version. Less frequent loss of father-child contact when the residents are near. It means loss in 33% of cases when they are more than 400 kilometers each other distance. In 81% when the father is not able to answer precisely about the duration of the trip because the trip is too long. Very interesting, in this authoritative casuistic, less frequent loss of father-child contact after alternating residence, at least in the beginning. 1% versus 21% when from the beginning you have the sole maternal custody. Before going to examine the European situation that, I mean, you can read at your homes, I try to determine if shared custody is in the paramount interest of the children. And now I talk a little bit about an important article that I presented last February in the Italian Parliament. Third take-home message: after more than 40 years since the debate began, we could not substitute, replace the theoretical, ideological approach with a more concrete, practical approach, grounded on the experience of the countries that have the courage to apply, to put in practice, the joint custody and alternative custody. And so this allows for an important evaluation, a scientific evaluation. And we have a lot of countries with established history of joint alternative custody. For example, we have the Italian law on the joint custody since 2006, but I found in the same year in Quebec, the official national statistic, I found that almost 30% of children already lived in alternating custody, spent 40 to 60% of the time with each parent. Perhaps are these children destabilized? Are there some problems? In Sweden, the best example, I mean, considered by different sources of the protection of the children, 28% of children from separated couples spent 4 years ago about 50% of the time with each parent. In Wisconsin, in 2008, 22% of children live 50-50, and 32%, more than 30% of time by parents too. In Washington State, 16% of children in the 2008, or better, 2007, because in the 8th was published the article. It was the same in Arizona and some other countries for USA. In my first research, I grounded on studies with some characteristics. They must be published on scientific reviews of international repute. Widespread is unusual to study research with a casuistic of 15, 20 children, at least 1,000, without geographic notation, because the literature is dominated but the scientific experience coming from USA. So I try to mix with the experience for Scandinavia, for example, from Belgium, and possibly with meta-analytic features, so it means a critical analysis of other research. Globally, it involves more than 200,000 children from different sociological contexts. The first one, Robert Bauserman, everybody should know because this is considered the first meta-analysis with a statistical approach of the scientific literature. It compares, you see, 1,846 sole custody children versus 814 joint alternating custody. At least it was considered joint custody 25% up to 50% of the time spent by parents too. We can measure a lot of parameters, but Robert Bauserman chose these ones: general psychic assessment, behavioral adjustment, emotional adjustment, self-esteem, family relationships, academic performance, psychic wellness, and the divorce. There was 21 research comparing physical joint custody versus sole custody. After you see, you can detect some other issue. The joint custody, these are the outcomes, giving the children, with statistical validation, this is very important, better outcomes independently from external variants and identity of the person who played the measure. Very interesting, the parental conflict was smaller between the groups in joint custody. A lower conflict between the parents could help to foresee a better assessment. So, what does it mean? It means that what is very important seems to be the joint custody and not the beginner low level of the conflict. And this is very interesting. I found some other times in other research, the comparison between physical joint custody in children with interfamilies didn't show any important difference. Or better, without statistical validation. A very interesting research is this one. Please, let's check the number. I mean, in Italy it's impossible to do research like that. I think the most of the European countries. The Swedish researchers, they have studied more than 15,000 children, 11, 13, 15 years old, about the use of drugs, alcohol, smoke, mental distress, victimization. The best outcomes of equal co-parenting had been with statistical validation on mental distress. But every parameter was better in the children living 50-50. Australia, very interesting. Co-parenting and shared custody, when the parents don't agree, become the first option in 2006. In few years, equal custody reached 16% of the children. And the outcomes on the direct effect on the conflict are evident. Because on the right belt, we see that the general claims increase, but you see the family court in few years, from 35,000, they decreased to 18,000, more or less. This is unbelievable research. Life satisfaction among children in different family structures. Please notice the sample. Almost 200,000 minor in 36 Western societies. It has been performed by 7 different universities of 6 different countries. This paper examines difference in life satisfaction among children in different family structures. First one, children living, first conclusion, first outcome. Children living with both biological parents reported higher levels of life satisfaction than children living with a single parent or parent, step-parent. So, the children, we know that, even the intact family can become a drama. But, on average, for the children, it will be better living on the big number, on the wide statistic, living with biological parents. But, second point, children enjoying physical custody reported significantly higher levels of life satisfaction, close to intact family children. And there's no other types of non-intact families that can reach the level of the children living in joint physical custody. And this researcher for joint physical custody say, we think that is joint physical custody half the time with the father, half the time with the mother. And after that, I bring you across the world in a scientific trip, but now you enter again the court. For example, the Italian court. And the judge doesn't want to know this research. And so we have some example of sentence of Italian courts. In accord to our jurisprudence, the court doesn't agree about time fragmentation. So Gianpietro de Man say one day per day, time fragmentation assuming it's destabilizing. So it means that 30% of the children of the best country in the world, Sweden, are destabilized. That Sweden is able to protect the children much less, much worse than Italy, I don't think. Recent sentence, court for children of Milan, the changing of domicile and of managing of daily deal causes the loss of steady reference points. Alternating domicile can produce negative effects on minors. They didn't read the research, for sure. Court for children of Trieste, this is of the last February, it's unbelievable. It's our study jurisprudence not allowing the alternating custody, neither the parents give the different flats on the same point. And the father, just to have asked regularly by a formal point of view, by a lawyer, by an attorney, has lost even the legal custody. You are not responsible to have asked for things that is noxious for your child. So in name of this tenderness, the judge denied attending weeks, no? Attending weeks, I mean, requires only 4 movements. In this one, 2 weekends, more 6 afternoon per month, 16 movements. Where is the steadiness? I told you, I tried to go fast because I wanted to gain some minutes. Even I can advise you that we don't have a precise time at 6 o'clock, but we can go over. This is the outcomes that you can find estimated equal custody in Europe. Sweden exact time division was at 25%, about 30%. Belgium exact time division about 20%. 20% is the average between, because we have 2 different categories. If you go in the front of the judge, more or less in Belgium you obtain equal custody in 13%, but if the parents agree, you have in 25 and the average is about 20. So the judge everywhere, I mean, try to check to impede the equal custody. After other belt, France, Denmark, Spain, and certain division between 8 and 20%, UK, Germany, and in the section 5, I mean, the worst countries about equal custody. You see Italy, Greece, the Switzerland, Czech Republic, something else. Physical joint custody, in this casistic, physical joint custody is a concept different. You change country and you find a different definition. For example, for UK, for Australia, it's 35% of the time spent by parent B. But if you go in UK, it's 30%, it's 30, 35 even. I choose 30%. So how many minors spent 30% of the time, at least 30% of the time with the parent B. Okay, Sweden, Spain, Belgium, Denmark, more than 30% of the children. France is in a middle situation between 15 and 30%. And after I found Italy, Switzerland, Greece, Austria, Germany, Czech Republic, Slovakia, UK, Romania, and Portugal, about under 15%. But there's a lot of parameters that that we can consider. For example, the average of the time that you have to spend by the parent B. And we see that, for example, my country is in a middle belt between 16 and 20%. Over 20%, so more time with the parent B, we find Sweden, once again, the first in every class, in every ranking. The Belgium, the France, the Germany, Spain, and Denmark. You find in the end the bibliography and the source of the data. And after we find in the bottom of this ranking Switzerland, Austria, Czech Republic, Slovakia, I mean a Mid-European block. So third take-home message. You see, the worst countries are in the south. It seems, especially in the Mediterranean area, that exists a thick wall between the world of the science and the world of the right. Perhaps because we suffered the influence of two geniuses, Renato Cartesio, René Descartes, and Giambattista Vico, for the Italians. They divided 400 years ago the world of the science, the world of the nature, and the world of the man, the world of the right. The USA, for example, they didn't take this division, and you find something today, tomorrow, is in the court. For example, the DNA test, in USA, entered the court a few months after that it has been discovered. In Italy, 5 years after. So how many violence against female, how many homicide has not been recognized? In Scandinavia, USA, they don't have this division. The judge is more open to the news coming from the laboratory, from the science research. They just love a more practical and less theoretical approach. And this is even the difference, I mean, between the Roman right and the Anglo-Saxon right. So the third take-home message, and for sure, you saw the data, European children are treated too differently according to their nationalities and legal system and they are subjected to. So it's absolutely necessary if we love our children, if you if we want to protect them, to make practice more harmonized by taking example from most advanced countries. This is possible. This is the revolutionary message that we must try to introduce in every our country, but for sure in Europe. Only replacing, changing, switching from a dominant, sectionalist, localist legal language to a more universal scientific language, allowing all children to have an equal right to have. Because I told you earlier, everybody when has the fever, take the paracetamol or something against the fever, for the temperature is over 38.5, then the fever began at 38. I mean, if you have a pneumonia, a tonsillitis, some disease, you are treated more or less in the same way from Stockholm to Athens. But if you see the way which the children are subject to, and you see that it's not like that. This is a sectionalist juridic language. We have completely to replace. If it will succeed, this will be our revolution. But unfortunately, even today, the juridical language dominates. This is interesting research, an example at the same time of the European Commission. You see, Directorate General Justice. They launch a research within the policy framework. The European Commission has launched a study to collect data on children's involvement in judicial proceedings in 27 European member states and Croatia, now 28, because Croatia entered a few months ago. The study will run from September 2012 to September 2014 to establish statistics and collect data based on structural process and outcome indicators on children involving criminal, civil, and administrative judicial proceedings. When I saw that, I made a jump on my chair because, okay, this is what I wanted to do. But I was wrong, because they want only to count the number of the children involved in parental divorce proceeding, the number of children involved in parental divorce during the 12-month period, only the rate of children involved in parental divorce proceeding. They want to know about the custody awards to a sole parent, the number of custody, but the problem is not only the custody, sole custody, legal joint custody. These are purely formal features. In fact, the problem is another one. The problem is the time. Children, I mean, let's think to our children. Children do not care if the parents adopted joint custody, sole custody, parental responsibility, with this small, little difference, a concept that a child cannot understand. Children only care about the amount of the time that will be allowed to spend with their parents after that. These are not my words, but a lot of Spanish. Juan Garcia Sanchez. Example, this is clear to demonstrate what I mean. Italy and Sweden have the same rate of legal joint custody. 89%, Sweden 93%. You could think that Italy is like Sweden, but about 30% of Swedish children live 50-50 by their parents, only 2% in Italy. And they must not say to the judge because you risk even to have the risk to lose the legal custody. So our judiciary systems move for the paramount, but I prefer to stay sometimes behind the paramount interest of the minors. But often we ask spontaneously ourselves, but how was this paramount interest defined in the beginning? This is very interesting because every country changes. And for me, the paramount interest must not change a lot. Switzerland is a fantastic example. Because the Francophone children, they are treated in a way completely different from the Francophone children of France or Belgium. It is in Quebec. So following the scientific evidence, it means that sociological feature is not so important because between the romantic Switzerland and the country, and the little town after the beyond the border, I mean, there's not so much difference to justify a completely different assessment. So following the scientific evidence, the stranger experience, the international literature, the literature that I show you, that I try to bring across some light, clever lawyers, like for example, Avvocato Pillon, to introduce, to enter the court. If they take home messages, not, for sure not. Not following the scientific evidence or the international literature or the stranger experience. Because every system chooses a different paramount interest. you change, you move of a few kilometers, and the pound meters change completely. You pass the border between the Switzerland and the France, it changed completely. So perhaps this paramount interest has been defined following the old habits, the personal opinions, the prejudice. Prejudice. But a judge should not ever have a prejudice. They need, see, judge the prejudice, and he's not fit for the judge. In Italy, for example, we have found 57 kinds of pre-printed schedules orienting the divorce when the couple didn't enter the court yet. So you believe to enter the court and to make a judicial process, a judicial claim. Probably the judge stay listening to you. In the end, he shake the hand, he say, please, go out. And after, he take. A paper where it's written everything. It's already written the people which will have the children for the maximum of the time. It's already written that, the male spouse must give money to the mother. Before the proceeding has begun, that's unbelievable. 57 has been deposited in the Italian Senate. This is, the justice of copies is not the justice which I believe in. And for sure, it was not the aim of the research, because the aim of the research, you see, in the research I didn't put a table with the different, but for sure, I saw that there's a scanty consideration of male parenting, this is for sure. I see that even in Sweden, not for sure like in Italy, the male parenting is not considered at all. That is the number you can find in the research. But the difference is the courage of admission for the Italian judge versus absolutely impartiality of the judge. In France, for example, a governative report has highlighted that French judicial system shows index of discrimination of parents according to sex. The report talks even about dissuasion to fatherhood. The report claims that although the law on joint custody, only 14, today are 16, 17 today, of minors as physical joint custody. Only 7% of custody is granted to fathers. 7 is the same. In Italy, we have a telling custody under 2%, so custody is 0.8. But we must accept the situation while, an authoritative source like the French government say for the France, we permit completely different that there was an important discrimination. What do the children think? There's a lot of research. I love this one. It's a wide sample. It was two psychologists from USA, from Arizona. They take the teenager, the first year of university, William Fabrizio and Jeffrey Lowe. This teenager entered the university to become psychologist. 820 was collected. They were, children from divorce couple. They say that they wanted to have spent more time with their fathers as they were growing up. The living arrangement, they believe, was best, was living was equal time with each parent. 93% between young who had experimented, not a lot, even in Arizona. 70% between adults. Okay, this is a research, that is known everywhere in the world. This is the focus of children according to the Italian judge. These are official documents of the Upper Council of Magistracy. So, all the judge must follow this, I don't say rule, but this address. The children, especially teenagers, are lazy and they prefer one living reference point, even more because they don't have the same personal belongings in both the houses. So personal belongings are worth more than one parent. But not in Quebec, but not in Sweden, but not in Belgium, but not in California, but not in Wisconsin. Now, I can close, yes. I have to close, and I will close with a little anecdote. Everybody knows Genghis Khan, the Mongolian people, the Mongolian tribu. They were in our notions. We are aware that they were absolutely cruel tribu, and they destroyed everything. But since 2000 years, that if a couple doesn't agree, so it's better to divorce. But you cannot expulse the father from the tribal group, because Mongolia is not by chance or by case. Mongolia, today in Mongolia, 80% of the population, 500,000 inhabitants, the 80% has alternating domicile. They move with the motor homes, they move with the horse. So, it's a good population to study, to research the effects of alternating domicile, because they don't have steadiness. In Mongolia, during the winter, you have minus 30, minus 40, and during the summer, you have more 30 degrees. It's a terrible situation. You cannot expulse the father after divorce from the tribal group. It will be weaker, the group, and the man will die alone in the wild nature. So he changed only the tent. During the night, he will not be husband anymore. But during the day, he will still be parent. And perhaps we have something to learn from the Mongolian tribe. Okay, since the 2000 years, Mongolian people say, he's happy the parent, warm children running in his arms, even when the hands are empty. Because I like to join my friends, that day, and only that day, we could say to have been a good parent in the name of our children. Thanks. I think to be practical, concrete person, people, in the end we have to plan the future. It has been a very nice, very beautiful afternoon, but at the end we have to see the program and the things we have to do in the future. For example, one thing that I have to suggest is to push your lawyers of your own countries to send in the court, to present, to the judge, the scientific literature, to change definitively these old rights. No more the world of the right against the world of the science, but a new right that resume the scientific evidence, for example. It's impossible that the jurisprudence can check, can impede the truth, the scientific truth entering the courts, for example. And everybody can do that, pushing his own judge, presenting. In Italy I've already begun, every lawyer collaborating with me is prepared to present to the judge scientific literature. And we have found an open judge. Not everybody, for sure. Someone. We have found even judges saying, but this is scientific language, this is another thing, I don't want to know anything. And this is a big trouble, because there's nothing worse than a judge wanting to know, to ignore. A judge who doesn't want to learn more. For a physician, for a doctor like me, it's unbelievable. It would be impossible to continue to heal the people without the continuing updating the course every month, because the world of the science run much faster than the world of the jurisprudence of the law. The jurisprudence and the law are the kingdom of the steadiness, instead of the world of the science, the scientific notion change about 70% every 15 years. We have some lawyers, and they know that it's not like that. It's not such a way in the world of the law. Very fast, very short. First point, the European Commission has affirmed that custody of the children concerns family rights. So therefore, in accordance to this opinion, there's no possibility of intervention. So if we continue to follow this road, it will not be possible to be helped by Europe. But for me, for the evidence we saw today, it's not correct. We have a lot of evidence stating that such a kind of problem concerns the health of our children. On the health, on the contrary, Europe has wide competence. So my research that you have is not the Bible. You can find some mistakes, but it's the first survey in Europe, because nobody tried to do this one earlier. I think that everybody reading it could have a good idea of what's happening beyond the border. So for example, 1 month ago, a French sent me a mail telling we have a big debate in the French Senate to approve a new law for the joint custody. But we heard that Italy is the kingdom of joint custody. No, you have heard wrong, my friend. You have to look to Wisconsin, to Sweden, to Denmark, but not to Italy. So now it will not be possible, because more or less we all have an idea of the European situation. It's clear that European children are treated differently, and sometimes with clear difference in fundamental right to have. I think something very close to discrimination according the nationality, according to the juridic system they are subject to. I think that this is a good instrument to continue our battle. It is necessary to make practice more harmonized by taking examples from most advanced countries. We have heard the situation in Switzerland or in Greece. We have heard about the situation, for example, in Belgium or in Sweden. You will read in the research. We all can think that the best is the Greece or the Switzerland or the Sweden. I don't know. I would say that the scientific literature say that the best is Sweden. But why the Swedish children must be treated differently from our Italian children, for example? This is possible in replacing, changing the dominant sectionalist, localist legal language. When a court is in Italy, but I think it's the same everywhere, doesn't want to know what's happening in the court 20 kilometers on the east or on the west. We have to change with a more universal scientific, because only this change can allow all children, can allow all children to have an equal right to health. So we can only ask the European Commission to establish concrete good practice. I will push on Honorable Angelilli to make that, to make an instance starting from the European Parliament to avoid this difference. In fact, today is available a huge amount of scientific literature on this topic. I would say that it's neither necessary to make new research. Probably would be enough to make a meta-analysis of the research already available. This stuff, because I believe in the Europe, but Europe cannot be defined as truly equal and fair until it does not ensure the same care and attention for all of its children. But now we have heard the situation of everybody. We know that defending our children will mean following a hard road, more or less like this ship in Greenland Sea. Thanks. No. Okay, thanks everybody.